Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. I will start with my introduction, like I always do with my classes. My name is Dr. Unayab Gazdar. I am a teacher, a university teacher, if you call them teachers. Some of us would like to call ourselves academicians, you know. So we can, you know, satisfy ourselves that, you know, we are not just teachers, we are doing something different, and we are to some extent. But anyways, I have been involved in university teaching since last 15 years. Yeah, it's been a long time. Okay, and so I am quite old, and if I don't look that old, that is a good thing. You can comment regarding that. Okay, I'll be happy. I have taught in Pakistan, okay, at least two universities in Pakistan, and I have also taught in Bahrain as well. I'm currently teaching in Bahrain, okay, and I have done my PhD in civil engineering, particularly in the field of transportation planning. Okay, and if you have seen my earlier videos, those were mainly focused on this topic. But now, I have decided that I should do something else which may benefit my colleagues, my students, people who are aspiring to be in this field for some unknown weird reason. Okay, so it's for them. Okay, and what I will be doing in this series is basically I'll be sharing my experiences, okay, which I have learned, as I said earlier, in a long duration of 15 years. So some of my old students may be hearing some things from me which may surprise them. They may say, why is this guy saying this thing now? He didn't believe in these things when we were being taught by him. Okay, so I cannot help it, you know, there are things which you gain with experience. Okay, and if you feel that, you know, those at that time I was not good enough, or what I'm saying right now is better than what I treated you, then I'm sorry for that. Okay, I'm extremely sorry, and I know I have made mistakes, obviously. This is a professional life, and you make mistakes, and that. So this is the first lesson. Okay, that never shy away from admitting your mistakes. Okay, because we are people, son of Adam or daughter of Adam. Okay, don't take me to be, you know, discriminant against any particular gender. Okay, it's just the way of speaking. So we are son of Adam, we make mistakes, that's how we are made, and the best thing is to admit your mistake. Okay, this is a hadith from the Prophet ﷺ as well, that the best amongst the progeny of Adam is the one who you know, repents for his mistakes. Okay, so that's it. That should be the main aim. Okay, whenever you recognize your mistake, you go back to it. No matter whether you are teacher, student. Okay, teachers are not totally devoid of making mistakes. They do make mistakes because they are as human as their students. The thing is that they have to admit it. And later on in this series, we will be talking about this particular aspect in more detail. Okay. So coming back to the series, this playlist in your YouTube, why I'm making this, because when I became a teacher, and it was right after I did my engineering, okay, so I was quite fresh in professional life as well as in teaching, and at that time I felt that I was a bit lost. Okay, so I don't want other colleagues to feel the same thing, my students, my juniors to feel the same thing. Okay, so I decided that I should share my experience. Maybe their lives will become a bit easier with my experience. Okay, and I took my inspiration from one of my colleagues. Actually, there was only just one colleague who gave me good advice at that time, positive good advice, like what you should do. Okay, there were other colleagues as well. Obviously, they were speaking for their heart as well. I don't blame them. Okay, but the main thing is when you get someone new in your field, you have to welcome them, okay, in a way that they should feel more comfortable. Okay, and I would like to mention the name of that colleague, that is Mr. Imran Ahmed. Okay, and he was my senior with couple of years. Okay, but the way he treated me and the way he welcomed me, and he was, you know, easing me into the role of being a teacher at the university level. And this is how the seniors should treat their junior colleagues, okay, whether it's engineering or any other field. Okay, this is my point of view. Okay, I will try during this series that I should not touch on the technical aspects and the conflicting theories in this field. Okay, the field of teaching and research at the university level. Mainly, I will be dealing with university teaching. Okay, like, because this is my area of specialization, this is what I have experience of. So I don't feel comfortable, and I don't feel it is ethical and fair to venture into any other field. Okay, the one which I'm experienced about. Okay, that is what I'm trying to this is what I'm trying to share with my listeners and with my viewers. Okay, so I'll be teaching in English because as far as I know, university teaching all around the world is in English, and so I feel the people who will get the most benefit out of it are the university teachers. So I will be talking in English, although I know other languages as well. Okay, obviously, I will be looking forward for your comments. Okay, if you want me to touch on a particular aspect, then I can do that. Okay, based upon your feedback. So feedback is important. Okay, now why the first thing which I am going to discuss in this video is the importance of teaching. Now, first of all, like I have said at the start, that this is mainly for university teachers, but in today's world, I feel that it is important to learn how do you distribute or how do you forward the knowledge to others. This is important. Okay, and there is a very good word which they are using nowadays instead of teachers. Okay, that is the influencer. Okay, that is the word which I have taken from the social media dictionary. Okay, and this is a very good terminology to explain and to point out what is actually happening with the social media and in today's world. Okay, how people are influencing others. Okay, so a teacher is basically an influencer. If a teacher is not an influencer, then he is not a teacher as well. Okay, if your teacher is not an influencer, then he is not a teacher. So in today's world, everybody is influencing the others. Okay, when you share something, when you are taking a picture and you are uploading it, when you are making a video, even when you are forwarding a video, okay, you are basically telling others what is your opinion, what is your point of view about the things which are happening around you. And by doing that, basically what you are trying to do is you are trying to influence others. And this is the job of a teacher. And this is the dilemma in today's world, that unconsciously everybody is a teacher. Everybody who has a social media account is an influencer at some level, and he is influencing others by means of his own contribution as well as others' contribution with which he is agreeing. Okay, but the point is, we are not taking it seriously. we are not taking our influence on others seriously. And this is where I feel an awareness has to be created. Okay. So, in this series, like I said, my focus is on classroom teaching, especially at the university level, and maybe I will get in more details and I will give you some examples about civil engineering and transportation engineering. Okay, but I will try to touch on the aspects which are equally important for a mature educational person who is on social media. And obviously I'm uploading these videos on YouTube and Facebook, so obviously you are on social media, that's why you are listening to me. So first of all, get this thing straight: you are influencing others when you are socially active online. You are influencing others when you are socially active online. Don't take it lightly. I was just reading a quote from a scholar, famous scholar, yesterday, and just keep one thing in mind. I don't like to name the scholars because some people, just by listening to the name, they, you know, totally judge the quote, and they just throw away what the other person is saying. Okay, so I may not be quoting the name of the scholar, but anyways, the quote was: before you speak anything, before you write anything, check within yourself, ask yourself this question: can I prove this thing in a court of law? If not, don't do it. Make your life easy, don't do it. If you can do it, go ahead, do it with full confidence. So this is the thing which we need to understand, that everybody who is socially active online is a teacher. You need to take it seriously. Whatever you are doing online, you will be questioned about it. Not by CIA, not by Mark Zuckerberg, not by the other people who are developing these websites, social media websites and applications. But keep this thing in mind: you will be questioned one day about what you did online. Okay, and as I said, when you are online, you are influencing others, so you are basically a teacher. Okay, so understand your role, take it seriously. Okay, whatever you're doing, take it seriously. Now so I will dedicate this first video to the importance of teaching. Okay, so I've already given you a brief overview, okay, that why this series is important for all of us. Even for me, when I say something, when I'm sharing my experiences, it gets a lot out of your mind, it makes you think and so on. Okay, so it is as important for me as well as it is for you. So now, why it is important to understand the importance of teaching? Okay, as I said, first of all, you will be questioned about it. There will come a day you will be questioned about it. So you have to keep this in mind. This is the first thing. And as I said, consciously, unconsciously, you are behaving like a teacher. Okay. Secondly, why is it important to understand the importance of teaching? Okay, why it is important? It is important. Let me give an example. Have you seen little kids playing with their toys? Okay, especially the very young ones, small ones, 1 year, 1 year and a half. You give them a rattle. Okay, and all it does is it makes this noise. It's very irritating, annoying. Okay, you cannot stand it more than 10 seconds. But that kid is enjoying it. Okay, he is enjoying it so much so that he does not care about anything else. Okay, whether he is in the lap of his mother or he's on the bed, he doesn't care about it. Okay, you grow older and the same thing happens with other toys. Okay, the toys change, but your interest is in there. Okay, if you have seen little girls playing with their dolls or boys playing with their guns, okay, I'm talking about artificial guns, okay, hopefully your boys are also still playing with artificial guns. So if you have seen them playing with these artificial guns and dolls, they are talking to the dolls, they are firing with the guns, shooting at this thing and that thing, and they totally take it seriously, and that's why they enjoy it, that's why they do it wholeheartedly, and that's why at the end of the day they are satisfied. Most of you would know, children take a toy, okay, they will play with it for some time and then they will get bored with it. Okay, I will not say they got bored with it. I would say they took the total utility out of that toy. Now they are satisfied that whatever we could have done, we have done it. Okay, so now I don't need a toy. I don't need this one. I need a new one. Okay, why? Because they have reached their level of satisfaction with that toy. Okay, it's a headache for the parents, but for the kid, if you understand his point of view, he was playing with it wholeheartedly and with full seriousness, and he was making up stories in his mind while he or she was playing with it. So at the end, he is fully satisfied, and this is what we want. Okay, so for them that toy is important. So for you, if what you are doing is not important, you will not get as satisfied with it, you will not do it wholeheartedly, you will not do it sincerely. All these things are important for any professional. Dedication, commitment, sincerity, these things are important. So if teaching is not important for you, don't do it at any level. Okay. University, school, college, Facebook, social media, whatever, don't do it. Okay. Now, why teaching is important? Okay, as I said, because you are influencing others, you are making up their minds. Okay, so it is important because of this reason, because you are doing something for others. Even the most criminal mind, even the most rude person understands the importance when you are influencing others, when you are doing something which will influence others. Okay. So even if you get into a car accident by mistake, by because of any other reason, weather or some other thing, it is still you have to call the police and the insurance company, and all these people are involved, and you have to report it, and you should report it. We don't do it so often, but we should report it. Why? Because you were endangering others. So even the most criminal mind and the most rude and selfish person understands that if you are influencing others, it is very important, because your life is your life, but others' life is a responsibility upon you. And when you are influencing them, then obviously you have to be more careful. Okay. So the first point of importance is you are. Whatever you are doing is not only limited to yourself, you are affecting others. Okay. Secondly, by influencing them, okay, you are also making your own personality as well. Okay, so each time you get a new batch of students, okay, and those students are basically influencing you as well, how you teach, how you talk, how you behave. Okay, so it's a two-way relationship between you and the students, and you are influencing each other. Okay, now let me give you some points about why teaching is so it's considered a noble profession. Okay, and obviously I'm a Muslim. I will give you the examples from the Islamic perspective. Okay, and I hope that even if there's a non-Muslim listening to it, he will still agree, because I've already mentioned some previous points which are general. So there is a saying of Prophet Sallam that the best among you is the one who who learns Quran and then he teaches others as well. Okay, so teaching is part of the trait of the best person, the best person from the nation. Another saying is Prophet Sallam said that I've been sent as a teacher. Imagine, the best person in this world sent as a teacher, and he is claiming it. Okay, so it's like an award. For example, I go to a new office and I say, I'm your boss, okay, or I'm your supervisor, I'm your manager. Okay, so he is claiming it. Okay, and the best person is sent because of this reason, he is claiming it. There's a saying from Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu that any person who teaches me one word, I'm a slave of this. Any person who teaches me one word, one new word, I'm a slave of this. There's a famous scholar, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayh, and he was giving he was teaching his students. So he was in a classroom, okay. And he stood up for someone during the class. He stood up for someone. You know who that person was? He was a cleaner. So people asked him, why did you do that? He said, that person told me once something which I didn't knew about dogs. Okay, famous scholar. You can search on Google. He has the highest number of followers from the Muslim nation. He stood up for a cleaner during the class because he considered him his teacher. The respect. So and this is agreed upon throughout the world that the amount of respect you will get being a teacher cannot parallel any other profession. The voluntary respect. You know, you are walking by, people are saying hi to you, salam to you. This is voluntary. You don't have guards around you. There is no protocol with you. People are respecting you voluntarily. And believe me, I have seen students who have failed in my course, who I have taught roughly, okay, sometimes I have been rude to them, still they see me, they will behave in a respectful manner. So this is the position which God has given. Okay, now this thing comes from the heart, and anything which comes from the heart is from God. Like the love of a child in the heart of the mother. This comes from God. So you, if you are a teacher in any capacity and people are treating you respectfully, that means, you know, the God has put your respect in their hearts. And then you have to, you know, you are getting something, then you have to give something in return. So the importance of teaching: first of all, you are influencing others. Secondly, your teaching is influencing you, so you are, you know, modeled according to your teaching mechanism, your teaching behavior. Thirdly, our teacher has, is considered the best in terms of. A teacher is considered as the best. Best among the society. So wherever I go, people talk to me and they ask me, what do you do? I believe me, I don't say anything else. I just say I am a teacher, and that's it. Their behavior changes. So the amount of love and respect you are getting from others, even from the people who you didn't teach, you have to, you know, this is evident enough that what is the importance of teachers in the society. Okay, and I've already given you examples, you know, from the religious point of view, from the spiritual point of view, that if you are teaching something good, that you are, then you are the best of the people in the nation. Okay, if you are teaching something like the holy word of Allah, the Quran, then you are the best, no doubt, undoubtedly you are the best. Okay, even obviously, you know, it doesn't mean that if you are teaching something which is for worldly gains, then you are not important. Again, all the other points are still relevant to you. You are influencing others, and you are taking their respect, and the God has put your respect in their hearts, and so on. So you are the most, one of the most important members of the society. If you are not doing your job properly, you will ruin generations. You will ruin generations. Okay. And generation doesn't mean it's a period of 20, 30 years. One batch of student is a generation. One batch of student is a generation. Okay. So, this is what I dedicated this video to, that you must understand your role in the society. Okay. First of all, you are a teacher. Okay, in a different capacity, even if you are not in a school or college or university, but you're still a teacher. Secondly, you are molding the entire generation of people, and you will be questioned about it. You will be questioned about it, no doubt. There is no doubt. Okay. You know, apart from the mercy of Allah, that, you know, He forgives whatever we are doing, and He says, okay, fine, okay, whatever you did, I'm happy with it, and if you, even if you made mistakes, I'm not going to question that. That is his mercy. But you must be prepared, or we must be prepared for questioning. Okay, and He has already put, Allah has already put your respect in the hearts of so many people, and in return, you know, you have to give your best. If you are not giving your best, if you are not careful, if you are not conscious, if you are not doing it sincerely with commitment, you are betraying yourself, you are betraying your profession, you are betraying your colleagues, your students, and most of all, you are trying to betray someone who knows everything. Okay, so now seek help from Allah as well, that He allows us and He gives us the strength to give, to do our job properly. Okay, and do your best. Okay, we should all do our best. Okay, especially in case of teaching, because you are not only doing it for yourself. Okay, so I hope you like the video, and you can give me your comments, and inshallah we will meet soon with some more things related to teaching. And I will, in the next videos, I will be talking more about my experiences. Okay, so in this episode, I've tried to, in this video, I've tried to focus more on the importance aspect, because that was not only my opinion or my experience, but in the next videos I will try to go deeper into the things which I have learned throughout my teaching life, my professional life. And I hope you are benefited from it, and I pray that Allah, you know, gives us the strength to do what is best for us and for others. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum.